I'm not a creator yet, but I'm producer and coordinator. So I start. So our institute was founded in 2004 and is run by VSPA Progress Foundation. VSPA is accommodated on premises of the former Gdańsk shipyard. And the founder are, it's our institution, winter time. So founders are Grzegorz Klaman and Aneta Szyłak. Grzegorz Klaman is sculptor and performance artist, activist, and also professor at Intermedia Studio of Academy of Fine Arts in Gdańsk. So he's since 1994, he is president of VSPA Progress Foundation, and since this year, he is also art director of our institution. To this time, art director was Aneta Szyłak, but it's changed. Aneta Szyłak is curator, independent curator, writer, researcher, and also is a director of Alternativa, it's very famous our project, international festival, and she has a long interest in located practice. Her exhibitions are characterized by a strong response to political and cultural, social and institutional particularities. And we have only 10 minutes for that. So they created the first Polish non-commercial and non-governmental institution of an international profile. Its character program grows directly from the specificity of the venue where it's located. So shipyard is very important for our program. Connect to history, tradition, on the one hand, and it's what's important. It's projected future on the other. So it was in 2004. Since 2004, they realized a lot of renovations and adaptations without financial support from developer or from municipality. It was a really huge project because it's 3,500 square meters and 1,500 meters for exhibitions. So it was one of them. And now it's reading room, our bureau, and it's here. And interiors are curatorial conceptions created by Aneta Szyłak and Grzegorz Klaman and many artists. And for example, it's work Maureen Connor. It's history of documented history of our building. And the next one is Maureen Connor. It's in office Aneta Szyłak. And this is a site-specific homage to Bruce Lee by Oskar Dawicki after his performance. VSPA has always been finding links between the area itself and the history of independent art movements of Gdańsk and the contemporary innovative artistic practice on the other. Your projects. We realized a wide range of activities. We are independent, non-governmental institution, but we have many activities like public institution because we have workshops, lectures, projections, temporary exhibitions. Maybe start from first exhibition. It's health and safety. It's created by Aneta Shuak and presenting artistic interventions in the building. And what was important also that it's the invited artists, curators, architectures, theorists took part in a debate about potential platform for international exchange. So it was really important first project when we start our all activities. The next one is example is Dog Watchers. It's also international project which refers to cultural and memory. We have a lot of partnerships, have many, we cooperate with many international places like Goethe Institute in Warsaw, French Embassy. So it's redesigning the East, it was also international project, and it was the research project conducted by between Central Europe and Asia. Invited countries was Poland, Germany, Czech Republic, Hungary, Korea, Thailand, and India. So we cooperate with Truffaut Gallery with projects and many curators from many countries. And it's new exhibition from that year, Elvin Flamingo. It's really interesting because it's your art. As well, exhibition was a doctoral dissertation Elvin Flamingo and the artist's intention, breeding exotic ants, was to create a film living its own life. And that project is still in progress. Project was presented simultaneously in our gallery and Gallery of Dance Gallery, and in internet also. And you can see it in internet, the project is very interesting. One of the most popular projects is Alternativa. It's an international contemporary visual art festival. Have series of exhibitions there, and it starts beginning. First edition was in 2010, and we realized 5 editions this year, titled Labor and Leisure, Estrangement, Materiality, Till Tomorrow, and Everydayness. It's examples of other exhibitions. It's Hito Steyer here in the Institute. Institute goes beyond the traditional understanding the concept of the gallery, but Institutes mean to do more than presenting new phenomenon of contemporary art, but also we concentrate intellectual background through, for example, collection. Since the 90s, Foundation create four own collection completely out of the public donation. It's just emerging by donation of artists. It's activist art. For example, we have works Zbigniew Libera, Krzysztof Wróblewski, Grzegorz Klaun also, a lot, Dorota Nieznalska, and many others. We have also archive, many photographs, films, and it's open for people if somebody is interested. And we have also also publications from our exhibitions, from Alternative also, Alternativa, our festival. We have also a residence program, and our residents, whose task is to introduce international group of researchers and artists and critics and theory and others, interested people, visual art. So we have also another another projects like Subjective Line. It's a history tour of the shipyard, which runs the route with specific points related to the history of solidarity. And the shipyard and what important, the guides are workers, shipyard workers who tell subjective stories. It's a kind of meeting with witnesses, participants in history, those less well known, but equally important. And the next part, the next project is Modelarnia. It's a place. It was a place set up by Vespa Foundation and as an artist cooperative to create a place where artists could create art, performance, and just meet and do art. But the place is demolished by developers in 2012. So it's not nothing, it don't exist now. Maybe something about financial matters. We don't have regular support from municipal. We raise funds from private donation and from grants of Department of Culture and from Goethe Institute, from Cronenberg Foundation or other institution. It's a lot through this, I don't know, 20 years our existing. So very important for our organization are volunteers, because we don't employ any wage workers. For that we have many volunteers every year. Since 2005, we are a public benefit organization also, so it's some donation for us also. And maybe something about future, it's the last thing. It's in the near future, we're going to refashion our building. We want to raise funds from European Union, and we're going to enlarge our space. Work for an artist and other activities, and also make the looks of the building more contemporary aesthetics. So, thank you for attention.